In this lecture, we'll discuss how astronomers measure stellar surface temperature and mass. And we'll begin with surface temperature. Measuring a star's surface temperature is easier than measuring luminosity because temperature doesn't change with distance. We determine surface temperature from either the star's color or its spectrum. Stars appear in different colors because they emit thermal radiation. A hot star like Vega emits more blue light, and a cooler star like Arcturus emits more red light. Astronomers can measure surface temperature by comparing a star's apparent brightness in two different colors of light. For example, consider the hot star Vega. If we compare the amount of light through a red filter with the amount of light through a blue filter, there will be more light in the blue because the star is hot, and hotter objects emit more light at shorter wavelengths. A star's spectrum provides a second and more accurate way to measure surface temperature. Spectra for hot stars look different from the spectra of cool stars. The types of spectral lines present in a star's spectrum can provide us a direct measure of the star's surface temperature. We classify stars according to surface temperature by assigning a spectral type determined from the spectral lines present. The hottest stars with the bluest colors are called spectral type O. The next hottest stars are spectral type B. The next hottest are type A, followed by F, G, K, and M, with spectral type M being the coolest. There are several mnemonics for remembering the spectral types. Here are two of them. Each spectral type is divided into 10 subcategories. A spectral type O0 star is hotter than an O1, which is hotter than an O9. The O9 is hotter than the B0 star, and so on. The coolest is M9. Our sun is a type G2 star, hotter than a G3, but cooler than a G1. Here are examples of the different spectral types. We can see that the hot O star has weak hydrogen lines because the surface temperature is so high that nearly all of the hydrogen is ionized. There's no electron to jump between energy levels. Stars displaying spectral lines of molecules like this M star must be cool because molecules would otherwise break apart into individual atoms at higher temperatures. The spectral type letters may seem a little random. The ordering of O, B, A, F, G, K, M stems from work that was done at the Harvard Observatory in the early 1900s. Stars can have surface temperatures ranging from about 3,000 Kelvin to 40,000 Kelvin. Cool red stars are much more common than hot blue stars. Now, on to how we determine stellar mass. Mass is generally more difficult to get at than surface temperature or luminosity. A dependable method for getting at the mass of the star uses Newton's version of Kepler's third law. To use Kepler's third law, we need to measure both the orbital period and the average orbital distance. For stars, this means we can measure masses only in binary star systems. About half of the stars in our galaxy are in binary systems. Binary star systems fall into three general classes. A visual binary is a pair of stars that we can see with a telescope orbiting one another. A spectroscopic binary is identified through observations of the Doppler effect in its spectral lines. An eclipsing binary is a pair of stars that orbit in the plane of our line of sight. When neither star is eclipsed, we see the combined light of both stars. When one star eclipses the other, the apparent brightness of the system drops because some of the light is blocked from our view. We can apply Newton's version of Kepler's third law only if we can measure both the orbital period and the separation of the two stars. Measuring orbital period is fairly easy. In a visual binary, we simply observe how long each orbit takes. In a spectroscopic binary, we can measure the time it takes the spectral lines to shift from blue to red as a star moves toward and away from us. Determining the average separation of stars in a binary system is usually more difficult. It's best if we have eclipsing binary stars because these stars orbit edge-on to our line of sight. In a visual binary or a spectroscopic binary, we do not know the tilt of the orbit relative to Earth. The overall range of masses for stars extends from as little as 0.08 times the mass of the Sun to at least 150 times the mass of the Sun. We'll discuss the reasons why this is a little later in the semester. That's all for now. Take care, and I'll talk to you again soon.